I can breathe. This feels so strange. Wish Lump could have been here. There was nothing I could have done. Was there? But there was no time to dwell on her lost friend.
Robin had a dragon to find.
Which way did it go? This one. All right. Another branching tunnel. The walls were closing in. Here, I guess. Far too narrow for winged beasts.
Did I guess wrong?
A dead end.
Wrong tunnel.
No. There must be a way.
Think, Robin, think. How do I get up there? Is this the right way? I just don't know. I wish I could ask Lump.
But there was no Lump there. No annoying little Lump to complain. No charming Lump to ask for advice either. The submerged tunnels flared outwards, a tangled mess of caverns and hollows, twisting and turning. Bending with almost malicious intent.
I need to get out of here. Breathe, Robin. Breathe. I've got to find the dragon. Get back the fireflies. You can do this, Robin. She found herself amidst a great coral bed, shimmering with color and life.
Wow! This is beautiful!
No! Focus!
I have to find the dragon. No matter what. Beautiful, and now... broken.
It grows back, right?
I have a dragon to find. I have to focus on that. No matter what.
She spoke those words.
But deep in her heart, a seed of chilling doubt took root. The color gave way to darkness, endless and all-consuming. cold here. Robbed of sight. The pressure of the deep water on her chest. Her thoughts had only one way to go. Inwards.
What am I doing? I let Lump sacrifice herself for me. And for what? I don't even know where the dragon is. Or where I am. I'm falling. I'm failing. Eldareva. The village. Lump. All of them. Huh? What? Air?
Cold determination gripped her, numbing all other thoughts. A cold determination gripped her, numbing all other thoughts.
Press forward. Get to the dragon. No matter what.
There was just the way forward, barred by an indestructible metal door.
No! I need to... find the dragon.
Robin could no longer ignore the seed of doubt.
I need to find it. The dragon. No matter what. No matter what.
The Seekin seemed friendly.
Hey, have you seen the dragon? Wait.
A host of them greeted her with curious chatter. Warm and welcoming.
Have you seen the dragon? Please. No.
But Robin had no time for this.
Let me through! I need to find the dragon. No matter what.
The words felt hollow and meaningless. Freezing cold blanketed Robin. There was comfort in its numbing embrace. She wished she could stay. She did this.
Is this my fault?
It was her fault.
The home. I destroyed it.
A seekin, encased in ice.
Oh no! What have I done? I'm so sorry. Please, forgive me. I never wanted this. I didn't know. I should never have come. What would Elder Ava think of me? I'm so selfish!
Guilt dogged her every step.
Did you make me do this?
It would not rest. Would not leave her. It would not cease.
Leave me alone! Must get away. Have to move. Need to escape. Please. I didn't know.
The creature looked at her as if it could see into her very soul. Under its stare, her fears crystallized like ice. She knew that she would... disappear. You'll make me disappear into nothingness.
I can't let that happen.
Would Robin embrace her guilt? Or run from it?
Have to fight it. Can't let it get me.